Good evening to all of you. In the last lecture, we have seen the different control structures in C programming language, and we started with the decision control structures, and we have seen all the statements which comes under decision control statements. Now today we are going to see the second part of control structures in C, that is loop control structures. Okay. So what do you mean by a loop in any programming language? Loop is nothing but doing the same thing again and again, executing the same code again and again is called a loop. There are three different types of loops available in C programming language. First loop is for loop, second is while loop, and third is do while loop. In every loop, there are three different parts, that is initialization, condition, increment or decrement. What do you mean by initialization? In initialization part, we actually initialize the variables used in a loop, which indicates the start point of the loop. Then we have condition to stop the loop or to terminate the loop. This is the end point of the loop. Every loop must have initialization and condition part. Then there is another part called as increment or decrement. Here we increment or decrement the variables used into the loop, which represent the steps by which we can jump into the loop. By default, it is jumping by one step. So all these three parts comes in all the types of loops available in C. Now we'll see the syntaxes and the differences among all the three types of loops available in C, that is for loop, while loop and do while loop. The simple syntax for for loop is, we write all the three parts of the loop in the same line by giving semicolon after every part. Like this, for in bracket initialization part, semicolon condition part, semicolon increment or decrement part, and we close the bracket here for loop. This is the body of the for loop. Opening and closing bracket indicates the code that we want to execute repeatedly with the help of for loop. So this is called as body of for loop. We have number of statements here in the body of the loop. Now we'll see the syntax of while loop. In the syntax of while loop, we do the initialization before writing the condition of the while loop. In the while loop, we first check the condition, and this block, in the block of the while loop, we write the third part of the loop, that is increment or decrement. See the syntax of do while loop. Here also initialization is done, and then in do block, we actually write the increment and decrement part, and then while exiting from the do while, we write the while condition. Condition is written here, and semicolon is at the last of the do while loop. The for loop will execute the number of statements into the body of the for loop if and only if the condition is true. The variables are initialized here, then the compiler goes to check the condition. If the condition is true, it allows us to enter into the body of the loop. We perform or execute the number of statements from the body of the loop. After completing one iteration, to go to the next iteration, the compiler goes to the third part of this loop, that is increment or decrement, to check the step by which we want to increment that variable. In while, we first initialize the variable of the loop, then we check the condition before entering into the loop. If the condition is true, then only the while loop allows us to enter into the while block, body of the while loop, right? So inside that, we can write our increment and decrement part to increment the iteration. Both the for loop and while loop, if you see, the condition is checked at the beginning itself. That's why it is also called as entry controlled loop. What do you mean by entry controlled loop? Take an example. Whenever you go to the college, on the gate itself, the security guard asks you for the identity card before entering into the college. So this type of process is called as entry control process. So in the for loop and while loop, these both the loops, in both the loops the condition is checked before entering into the loop. If the condition is true, then and then only it allows you to execute the code from the while or for loop. Otherwise, it won't allow you to execute any line of code from for loop or while loop. So these two are entry control loop. Now we'll see the third syntax, that is do while loop, where the condition is checked at the last, at the end. It means that this is called as exit control loop, because the condition is checked at the exit point. That's why it is called as exit control loop. The first two loop, for loop and while loop, never terminate by semicolon. If you see the third different point in the difference of all the loops, for loop never terminates by semicolon. Similarly, while loop never terminates by semicolon, but the do while loop always terminates with semicolon. Now, what happens if the condition is checked at the beginning itself? If the condition is false, the for loop will not allow you to execute a single line of code from the body of the loop. Similarly, in while loop also, if the condition is false for the first time, it won't allow you to execute any line of code from the body of the loop. But in case of do while loop, the condition is checked at the exit point. It means that if the condition is false for the first time, it allows you to execute the code body of the while loop at least once without checking the condition, right? So if you see in the syntax, it allows you to directly enter into the loop, allow you to execute the code at the first time, and if you are entering at the for the first time, at the end it is checking the condition. No matter whether the condition is true or false, it allows you to execute the code from the do block at least once. So this is the major difference between for loop, while loop and do while loop. If the condition is false for the first time in for loop or while loop, no line of code will be executed from the body of that loops. But in case of do while loop, if the condition is false for the first time, even it allows you to execute the code at least once. This is the difference between while, do while and for loop. Now we'll see one example just to print first 10 natural numbers using all the types of loop. We can perform any program by using any loop. It is the user's choice to which loop he prefers, right? If the program is like this, suppose I want to print the first 10 natural numbers, I can use for loop, I can use while loop, or I can also use do while loop. The same program can be written by three different ways and you will get the same output on the screen. Now, how to write this program to print first 10 natural numbers using for loop? We'll declare a variable I here. In for loop, we'll initialize I value as 1. That is the starting point of printing these natural numbers. This is the start of the loop. Then semicolon. Condition is the termination of the loop. A condition which terminates the loop. That is I less than equal to 10. Semicolon I plus plus. Inside the body of the loop, we'll just print the value of I. Right? So, first of all, it check the condition, initialize the value of I to 1, then it check the condition whether 1 is less than or equal to 10 or not. The condition is true, it prints 1. It allows you to enter into the loop and it prints 1. From here, it goes to the third part and increment the value of I by 1. Now, the value of I becomes 2, and again in the second iteration also, the condition is true, it allows you to print second value, I value is 2. Okay. Like this, the printing goes on till I becomes 10, I value 10 also gets displayed. Later on, when it increments for 11th iteration, I value becomes 11, and the condition after that for checking is 11 is less than equal to 10, the condition becomes false. So at this point, it exits from the loop, for loop. So it stops executing the code when I value becomes 11. So it allows you to execute the code till the condition is true. So this is the three line of code which will print the first 10 natural numbers. Now we'll see the same program, how to write the same program using while loop. In while loop, we initialize the value of I equal to 1. Then we check the condition into the while, that is I less than equal to 10. Then in the while loop, we are going to print the value of I, and in the while loop or body itself, we will increment the value of I by 1. Now, how this code gets executed? Check. I value is initialized to 1 here. Here, in the next line, we are checking the condition. If the condition is true, then and then only it allows you to enter into the while block and print the value of I as 1 here, because the condition is true for the first time. Now, I value becomes 2 by the second line, that is I equal to I plus 1. From here, it goes back to check the condition again. Check whether 2 is less than equal to 10. Again, the condition is true. It allows you to print the value 2 also. Again, I gets incremented by 1 like this. Till I becomes 10, it allows you to enter and it allows you to print the value 10 also here. When I value becomes 11 and it goes back to check the condition becomes false. So, this ends the execution of the while loop in the program. So, like this, it prints all the 10 natural numbers. Now, we will see the same code using do while loop. Initialization part, we assign I equal to 1. Then, in the do block, we will first print the value of I, and in the next line, immediately we will increment the value of I by 1. And at last, while closing the while loop, do while loop, we will write the while condition as while I less than equal to 10. Now, we will check how it going to print out first 10 natural numbers. Here, I equal to 1. Without checking the condition for the first time, it directly prints the I value 1 on the screen. Then, I will be incremented by 1, that is 2. It means here in the while loop, it directly checking whether 2 is less than or equal to 10. The first condition, that is I less than or equal to 1 less than or equal to 10, was not checked. And directly we are checking here 2 less than or equal to 10, and the condition is true. From here, it allows you to enter again into the do block. It prints 2. Again, the value gets incremented by 1. Like this, till I becomes 10, it allows you to print all the values. When I becomes 11, the while condition becomes false and it stops the execution of do while loop also. So, this is the difference of syntaxes in for loop, while loop and do while loop. We can write any program by any loop, but remember one thing, that if you know the source and destination, it means the start and end point in the loop, then for loop is the best choice for any user, because it is very simple to write the start point, end point into the for loop in the same line. We use while or do while loop only when we don't know in advance how many times that loop will going to execute. It means we know the start point, but we don't know the end point. That time we will prefer to use while or do while loop in the coding. So, this is the programmer skill to judge the problem and use the appropriate loop for the program. So, this ends the concept of loops in C programming language and the differences among all the types of loop. If you have any doubt, you can ask me now on loops. Thank you for watching the video.